The line from your government is that Israel has a right to defend itself. But when does that right get compromised and look like it is, in fact, a mass collective punishment that's being applied?
You know, 3,000 Palestinian deaths, approximately, 1,000 of which are children. You've got homes, schools, medical centres destroyed. That's before we even contemplate how they'll get rebuilt. No food, fuel, medicines, water. And it's no surprise that there are some saying that this is the collective punishment being extended to Palestinians. I think.
And do you see it as collective punishment?
I feel very strongly that Palestinians are being collectively punished here for Hamas's barbarism. I really do feel that there is an obligation on governments, particularly the Israeli government, to, as we have said, follow the rules of international law and to observe, in particular, that innocence should be protected. And I am very mindful of the words of our Prime Minister in saying that protecting innocent lives is not a sign of weakness. It is a sign of strength. And I think that is a really important thing that needs to be considered. And I genuinely believe there needs to be a de-escalation. I don't think it's in Israel's interest long term to engage in the occupation of Gaza. And it's not in Israel's interest and certainly not in Palestine's interests. And I do think that this is a moment where we have to recognise there is a humanitarian catastrophe occurring in Gaza. We force basically half the population into the south and Gaza itself being roughly smaller than the size of Canberra. You just appreciate how difficult this is for innocent Palestinians.
I can imagine it would be very difficult.